Hey there, fellow scientists! It's Justin again. Today, we're talking about extreme weather. You know, thunderstorms, tornadoes, the... that doesn't sound good. Is that, an extreme weather siren? Ooh, maybe we should get a move on. We need to learn about extreme weather so we know how to stay safe. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to describe three different types of extreme weather and explain some tips for how to stay safe from them. Let's investigate. We know that weather is what's happening in the atmosphere around us. Sunny skies, windy days, rainy afternoons. Weather usually changes gently. A little warmer here, a little rainier there, but sometimes conditions come together to create something extreme. When weather is much stronger, more powerful, and more dangerous than usual, we call it extreme weather. In our last lesson, we learned that the sun heats the earth unevenly. That uneven heating causes winds to blow, clouds to form, and temperatures to change in the atmosphere. Extreme weather happens when these normal forces of weather, heat, air, and water, get supercharged, meaning they gain a lot more energy very quickly. Today, we're looking at some of the most powerful kinds of extreme weather and how they each form. Imagine you're outside and deep, dark clouds start to roll in. Then, crack! A flash of lightning streaks across the sky. Thunder rumbles, and rain starts falling in huge, heavy drops. This is a thunderstorm. A thunderstorm is a powerful storm with lightning, strong winds, heavy rain, and sometimes even hail. Thunderstorms are one of the most common types of extreme weather, but they can still be very dangerous. A thunderstorm forms when warm, moist air rises quickly into colder parts of the atmosphere. As the warm air rises, it cools and condenses into giant, towering cumulonimbus clouds. Inside these clouds, tiny pieces of ice and water bump into each other, creating static electricity. Have you ever felt a little shock after touching a doorknob or maybe after sliding down a plastic slide at the playground? Lightning is made of the same static, but on a much larger scale. When the static inside the clouds gets strong enough, zap, lightning flashes across the sky. The lightning heats the air so fast that it bursts outwards with a loud boom. That boom is thunder. A single bolt of lightning is hotter than the surface of the sun. It can set trees on fire or damage buildings. Heavy rain from thunderstorms can quickly flood streets and fields, and its strong winds can knock down trees and power lines, cutting off electricity for whole neighborhoods. What do you think you should do if you're outside and you see dark clouds and hear thunder? Because thunderstorms can grow quickly, it's important to be prepared. The best way to stay safe during a thunderstorm is to go indoors right away and stay away from windows. If you're caught outside, get low to the ground and stay away from trees and tall objects that could be struck by lightning. Thunderstorms show us how powerful the atmosphere can be. And under the right conditions, a thunderstorm could give rise to something even more extreme, a tornado. Have you ever seen a storm where the clouds twist and stretch into a spinning funnel? That twisting column of air is called a tornado. Tornadoes are some of the fastest, most powerful winds on Earth. They can form during strong thunderstorms when the air is especially unstable. Strong winds blowing in different directions can start to spin the air sideways. If warm air rises quickly enough, it can tilt that spin upright, forming a narrow, fast-moving funnel cloud. Once a tornado touches the ground, though, it becomes a powerful force of destruction. The winds inside are strong enough to rip the roof off a house or flip over a car. Anything that isn't tied down can be lifted and thrown through the air. To stay safe during a tornado, it's important to act quickly and calmly. The safest place to go is the lowest level of your home, like a basement. If you don't have a basement, find a small, windowless room near the center of your house, such as a closet or bathroom. Stay low and cover your head to protect yourself from flying objects. Tornadoes strike quickly and often without warning, but not all extreme weather moves that fast. Some storms build slowly, gaining incredible size and strength over time. Imagine standing on the shore and seeing the waves crash higher than ever before. The wind roars so loudly you can barely hear your own voice, and the sky seems to stretch with endless gray clouds. This kind of storm is called a hurricane. A hurricane is a huge, swirling storm system that forms over warm ocean water. It brings extreme winds, heavy rain, and powerful ocean waves that can flood entire coastlines. While other extreme weather can form and disappear quickly, hurricanes take time to build and can last for days. Hurricanes begin when warm water heats the air above the ocean. That warm air rises and starts to spin because of the Earth's rotation. As more warm, moist air gets pulled in, the storm grows larger and stronger, forming a swirling system with calm air at the center, called the eye. From space, hurricanes look like enormous spirals of clouds, sometimes stretching hundreds of miles across. As a hurricane moves toward land, it brings dangerous winds that can knock down trees and buildings. Heavy rain can cause flooding in cities and neighborhoods. Powerful ocean waves called storm surge can push water far past the shore and into streets and homes. What would you do to prepare if you knew a hurricane was headed your way? To stay safe during a hurricane, people often need to leave their homes before the storm arrives. This is called an evacuation. If you're told to evacuate, it's important to leave right away and go somewhere safe. If you have to stay where you are, go to the strongest part of the building, away from windows, and have supplies like water, food, and flashlights ready. Hurricanes are some of the largest and longest-lasting storms on Earth. They may move slowly, but it can take a long time to recover from the damage they leave behind. That's why it's so important to prepare early, listen for warnings, and take action to stay safe. The three types of extreme weather we explored today, thunderstorms, tornadoes, and hurricanes, are powerful forces of nature. But they're not the only ones. There are many other kinds of extreme weather too, like blizzards, floods, droughts, and heat waves. Each one affects the world in different ways, and scientists study all of them to help us stay safe and understand how our planet works. Let's review everything we've learned today. Extreme weather happens when the normal forces behind weather gain a lot of energy quickly. Thunderstorms bring lightning, heavy rain, and strong winds. In a thunderstorm, stay indoors and away from tall objects. Tornadoes are fast, spinning columns of air that can cause major damage. Go to a low, windowless room to stay safe from these. And hurricanes are large storms that form over warm oceans and bring strong winds, flooding, and storm surge. If there is a hurricane coming, evacuate if you're told to, or shelter in a safe part of a building with supplies. To learn more about extreme weather, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Ugh, you know, looking outside, I don't see any signs of extreme weather headed our way. No swirling winds or lightning strikes. Phew! So what was that siren about then? Oh, Mia, it was you? Yeah, you're right. It's always a good idea to run safety drills to make sure we're prepared for extreme weather. Just next time, maybe give me a little warning before the warning, all right? Keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time. Hey, hey.